How did we get this far? Human beings have an immeasurable desire to discover, to invent, to build. Our future depends on us furthering these ideals. A responsibility that rests on the shoulders of generations to come. But with every new discovery, there is risk. There is sacrifice. And there are consequences.
Oh, gods, where do I begin? It's terrible, not fun, good, entertaining, or anything like that. Terrible! It's the worst thing it could be. Bland. It's tepid, bland, flavorless, boring, tedious, uninspiring, pedestrian, stock piece of cookie cutter by the numbers, made by accountants, filler that exists only to fill a spreadsheet of a movie. Minutes later, I've forgotten about a lot of what happened because it didn't have anything actually happen for the most part. There are a few good things that this movie has. The whole teleporting to another dimension, as opposed to the old-school space race of the 60s, is actually a clever take on the whole explorer's vibe of the comics. They managed to make this clever idea and ruin it, of course, but it's still clever. Additionally, about halfway through, when they come back from Planet Zero, yes, it's actually called that, the movie takes on a dark body horror movie vibe. Honestly, this is the best part of the movie. The movie spends the time treating the changes to the main characters with actual horror and fear. It's probably the best-paced, creative portion of the movie. Not to mention the only part that really stands out anyway that is memorable. The actors are given the worst, stilted, drab, and worthless dialogue that has been written. Every line issued by Sue Storm, Kate Mara, is pointless. Given as read, and develops nothing of the character. She does nothing. She could be replaced with a cardboard box, and no one would be able to tell the difference in the movie. Miles Teller's Reed Richards has no lines or really anything to contribute other than science, science, blah, 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 science, blah, blah, blah. No character development, no reason to give a damn about him or anyone else. Michael B. Jordan, our Human Torch, tries. Bless his heart, does he try to do something, anything, with the terrible script he's been given. But nothing can save this script, no matter how hard any of the actors try, and some definitely did not try. No jokes, nothing hits, even at the edges of a target, falling short by miles. Next, we come to my two favorite characters of the Fantastic Four, The Thing and Dr. Doom. The Thing is supposed to be this larger-than-life character with the most iconic line of the series. It's clobbering time! This movie takes this character and turns him into a pile of rocks with no personality. Damn you, movie. This pantsless pile of rocks is just a disappointment, ruining a great character by making him into a terrible and flat thing. Now we come to this movie's greatest sin, character bankruptcy, Victor Von Doom. The greatest, most extravagant, largest, towering villain Stan Lee and Jack Kirby ever created. From this, I get that Fox hates Dr. Doom, but to turn such an awesome villain into an environmentalistic piece of microwaved action figure with a green LED rammed up his ass is a crime. Doom in this is upset with humanity for ruining the Earth. Yep, Fox shoehorned an environmental message into this to create something akin to a motivation for Doom. When we finally get to Doom, we see the design of this thing. He looks like they just melted an action figure of Dr. Doom, jammed a couple of LED lights into the cooling plastic. I have nothing else to say that wouldn't be repeating how insulting the character and costume design of Doom is. Beyond all of this, it has the audacity to drag on and on around that good horror section of the middle, which isn't near enough to recommend seeing this at any time. Nothing is good or even worthwhile in this movie. The dialogue is stilted and flat-out painful. The costumes are drab, black and gray pieces of dross that have not been seen in a superhero movie since the original X-Men movies. There's absolutely no reason to care about what happens to anyone in this movie, with one exception, the sleazy government lackey Dr. Allen. They make this guy so hateable that when Doom causes him to explode in his own hazmat suit, that it wakes you up from the boredom of the rest of the movie. Which makes Tim Blake Nelson's performance the greatest in this movie. Don't see this, don't rent it, don't bother with it. When the horror scene ends up on YouTube, watch that and you've seen all you need. This is the worst kind of movie. No one in it cares they are in it. No one making it gives a single ounce of a care in this sewage runoff of a movie. The only ones who cared a single bit are the execs and accountants of Fox, in that they are clearly want to try and fuck Marvel Studios out of the rights of their products for as long as they can, and when Marvel does get them back, they are so fucking tainted that they can't use them. Want to psychologically scar a hated enemy? Go buy them a ticket and tell them this is the greatest Marvel movie ever. Or take this steamy pile of awful of a movie, strap the enemy into a chair, lock their eyes open, and make them repeatedly watch this over and over and over a la Clockwork Orange. There is nothing to expect from this movie because you will get nothing from it, except it will spark anger at the makers of the movie if you like the Fantastic Four even a little, even the teeniest bit. Beyond that, this doesn't even deserve to exist. Now that is not enough to polish his turd. Nothing could polish his turd. They ruin interesting characters and the greatest villain in Marvel Comics history. So, since the comic is a colorful, character-driven series, the producers clearly took that to heart and made a drab, gritty, realistic, i.e. cheaper film. Miss that. Good job, guys. The sets and locations are all boring, the costumes don't do anything to draw the smallest of inspirations from the source material or spark an interest in anything.